What a weird week for Friday, February 2nd, 2024. The one with the Groundhog Day song.
Hi, everybody, it's weird.
This is like crazy being here. Like
really weird tales.
Well, I got a great show for you today with some wonderful weird stuff.
Hi, friends, I'm Scott. Thanks for coming back or checking out the What a Weird Week show. We catch you up on the weird news of the week. New episodes every Friday. If you want the transcript of today's program or links and stuff like that, click shownotes.page, shownotes.page.
10.
More romance in the news ahead of Valentine's Day. Last week we talked about the zoo that will name a bug after your ex and then feed that bug to a zoo animal. Now a New Jersey animal shelter will name a feral cat after your ex and then neuter or spay that cat. Should we be doing, I'm not a psychologist. I'm just wondering out loud, is it healthy to do things like this? Does it help you to move on? Or is it something else going on in our brains when, Charlene broke my heart. There is no doubt about it. Charlene, if you're listening, a million pieces. Anyway, I'm not sure what the right answer is. It helps the shelter and it helps control the feral cat population in New Jersey. So there's that.
9.
Super Swiftie breaks world record. This fellow in Pakistan, 20-year-old fellow, who was able to break the world record for the most Taylor Swift songs identified from their lyrics in 1 minute. The world record now 34 Taylor Swift songs in a minute. Maybe you want to try to break the record this weekend. It's quite straightforward. You have to listen to the lyrics, identify the songs, no peeking, wear a blindfold. It looks like it takes intense concentration. Is there nothing that Swifties can't do? Hey, Swifties! Thanks for checking out the What a Weird Week show. We catch you up on all the weird news of the week. New episodes every Friday.
8.
There's been another souping of famous artwork in the news. We've covered stories like this before on the show. The Mona Lisa this time got souped. You know, that's pretty famous. That's up there. A lot of times you hear these stories and it's like, oh no, the priceless artwork. What's going to happen? The climate protesters whip soup or some gooey substance at famous artworks. But the art world folks are no slouches, and all these famous art pieces are now behind glass or some sort of soup-proof protection barrier. So the Mona Lisa got souped, and then basically somebody from the museum came along and cleaned the glass, and then people were able to enjoy the Mona Lisa once again. I assume that it did smell a bit soupy in the Mona Lisa room for a while. I'm not sure about this one, you guys. I believe that the environmental protesters are trying to save us all, and that attacking priceless works of art is certainly one way to go, I guess. But that's, I don't understand. I don't know how to feel about it. I don't understand art. I don't understand soup, really, either. So this whole story, very confusing to me.
7.
Lego man sets world record. A fellow named Miloš from Czechia has enjoyed Lego since age 5 and now has a Guinness World Record for the largest collection of Lego sets. Over 6,000 Lego sets. That was the last time they counted, in the summer. And now he has his official Guinness plaque. It was in the news this week. One neat thing is, it's not just a situation where now you see with people collecting those Stanley tumblers where you see the video and it's like, oh, I never drink it. It's a big wall of Stanley tumblers. And they're like, I never drink out of these. These are my special collector's items, Stanley mugs. Lego Miloš had the idea, hey, I want to share my Lego with the world, my wonderful collection of blocks. So he started the Museum of Bricks in Prague. So now you can see a whole bunch of Lego at the museum there. And I'll tell you what, if you were thinking about getting into Lego, maybe I just want to start with one set. What's a good set? To me, I'd go right to Miloš, the world record holder, because he's seen them all. Miloš says his favorite set is the Statue of Liberty, you guys. Actually, a pretty cool photo. We'll link in the show notes. All the Legos are set up, or Lego blocks. I don't know. I think you're supposed to say Lego blocks. Anyway, they're all set up. Pirates, jungle themes, so many castles. It's pretty cool. Shownotes.page if you want to check that out.
Let's get back into the weird news on What a Weird Week.
Giant world record bouncy castle in the news. We want to send a shout out to Hoops at UPI. Hoops is in charge of weird news, I think, over at UPI. Yeah, seems to be always on the weird news beat and does great work in the weird genre. So this one from Hoops. There's a tourist attraction bouncy place in Pakistan that is the largest bouncy castle in the world. We will link to the drone footage, the flyover from the drone. It looks like a small village. It looks like a town where you could move in. You could just live there. New Bouncington. If I moved in, maybe I would call it New Bouncington. I don't know. We could probably do better. Feel free to reach out. What's a good name for the village that is, in fact, a bouncy castle? It's quite incredible. If you don't have a chance to click on the photos or watch the video, I will explain it to you. It is a bouncy castle. That's all, but it's very, very, very large, 15,000 and something square feet. And so that is the largest bouncy castle in the world. They say you can fit 200 people on it.
Five.
Crater of Diamonds State Park is back in the news. This is a state park in Arkansas where you're allowed to go and look for diamonds. And we've talked about this on our program before because every year somebody finds a diamond there that's quite substantial, it seems. This time around, a visitor from France found a 7-point-something carat diamond. You just, again, to reiterate, you go to this state park in Arkansas and you find diamonds. And the name of the place is Crater of Diamonds State Park. Why is it not lined up more than Disney World? I don't understand. Shouldn't it be lined up out the door and down the freeway? There are diamonds. Maybe it's that where the diamonds are. It's also bears and cougars. Maybe it's a bear and cougar hunting ground and also diamonds. Could that be the thing? Still, that would be exciting. You got to get in fast, get your diamond before you get hunted by a bear. Actually, write that one down. That seems like a movie I would watch. Who do we send that one to, you guys? The people who make the Jurassic World knockoff movies. They'd make our diamonds and cougars movie, wouldn't they? Or that maybe the cocaine bear producer would want to take a look at our script. Anyway, I feel like we're about to be rich. Hello, Hollywood. You're tuned in to the What a Weird Week show. It's a top 10 countdown of weird news. Thanks for listening.
Four.
This one made the national news here in Canada. The McRib is back. I'm not sure if you've tried the McRib, if you have the McRib, if it's available where you're at. The pork sandwich that is the McRib was gone for 10 years here in Canada, and fans rallied and I assume protested in front of McDonald's headquarters. I don't know. For 10 years, every day for 10 years, it was nonstop signs and slogans and marching. And finally, it worked. After 10 years, we've got the McRib back. McDonald's says it's for a limited time, but then they also say, I'm paraphrasing, but it's sort of like, hey, you never know, McRib fans. Maybe it'll come back forever. Paraphrase. But well done to you hardworking activists who worked so diligently every day for 10 years to get the McRib back. Well done. Enjoy your victory. And thank you on behalf of a grateful nation.
Three.
Woolly rhinos are in the news. First of all, I had no idea they existed. Well, they're extinct now. But woolly rhinos, much like the woolly mammoth, there used to be woolly rhinos. Rhinoceros.
wandering this great planet of ours that were woolly, you guys? And scientists have extracted some DNA of woolly rhinos. We've talked about before on this program how scientists want to bring back the dodo bird, maybe clone the dodo bird. And scientists want to perhaps clone the woolly mammoth. And so I assumed the woolly rhino was added to that list, but it looks like maybe not yet. The article says the DNA sequence might have considerable degradation. So to be continued on cloning an army of woolly rhinos. But here's why the story is fascinating to so many, and it's getting shared a lot. It's how they got the DNA for the woolly rhino. They got the DNA out of fossilized hyena poop. So where you and I might see a rock that at one time was poop, these scientists saw an opportunity to get some DNA for the woolly rhino. There are scientists who study fossilized poop, you guys, in hopes of getting DNA. That's weird, right? Is it? I think it is. Anyway, the article gets into how they extracted the DNA and what it was like to be a woolly rhino and where hyenas of old used to do their business. It's a little bit of everything in this article from Popular Mechanics. We put a link in the show notes. Counting down the weird stories of the week, this is the What a Weird Week show. There's a story in the news about a mysterious noise in Florida and fish. I should have said PG-13 first. Hold on. PG-13. All right, there's a story in the news about this weird noise in Florida that people are taking note of, and it may be fish, you know, doing what comes naturally. Expressing their love for one another. You can hear fish doing that, apparently. I didn't know that. This is Tampa, Florida. There's a scientist investigating a strange noise. The neighborhood folks say it sounds, well, they describe it in the article. Well, I'm just going to read it the way they describe it in the article. A penetrating noise. Residents of the neighborhood, quote from the article, residents of a neighborhood in Florida, Tampa, Florida, have been frustrated by a mysterious bass sound, and they've learned that the mating process for the black drum fish could be responsible for all the racket. So these poor people in this neighborhood in Tampa, I mean, they called in noise complaints to the police about this. That's how loud it is. They didn't know what it was. They thought somebody was having a rave. Called the police. It's been going on for years. Finally, they contacted a scientist. They raised money to hire the scientist. And this scientist from a marine laboratory and aquarium is going to get to the bottom of it. The plan is to get some microphones underwater and, you know, follow up on the fish theory that it's a Netflix and Gills situation.
Counting down the weird news of the week. This is What a Weird Week.
Honorable mention.
If you're new to the program, sometimes we have more than 10 weird news stories and ones that haven't quite made the countdown but are still worthy of being mentioned. Here we go. The lady in California and the world record. I find this one off-putting. I don't know if I should say PG-13. I mean, we're all God's children and, you know, it's just something, it's just a normal, natural thing. Well, you be the judge. How about that? I'm happy this lady got into the Guinness Book of World Records. She seems like a nice lady. She was smiling proudly, holding her world record plaque. She has the world record for the longest arm hair for a female. 7.2 inches long arm hair. And there's a photo. And once you see the photo, you cannot unsee the photo of the arm hair. So maybe that's something, maybe just my description was enough for you. But if you want to have a look, we put a link in the show notes. Coming up next is our number one story.
Weird. Weirder. Weirdest. The What a Weird Week Show.
One.
Our top story this week was all over the place. We got the article from Gizmodo, but a lot of different sources had this one. The headline is Japan Zoo recaptures escaped man in costume in adorable emergency drill. So at the zoo, they have this thing where they practice, what would you do if a bear got away? And they do it every year. I think we even talked about it on this program before because it's in the news when it happens because it is very unusual looking. They hire someone or an employee gets dressed up as a bear and then the zoo, they take that bear down. Tranquilizer darts, bear traps, bear spray, tasers, all of it. No, I'm just kidding. They don't do that part. It is something where people watch and cheer on the employees and it's very lighthearted, but it's just to make sure it really is a training program to make sure everybody can logistically get in place and handle it if a bear ever escaped, how to recapture a bear. I'm glad they know how to recapture a bear. Or, I mean, in the event that someone in a bear suit also gets loose, they've got that covered too. Two birds, one stone. Hey, you guys, two bears, one stone. Didn't work. It didn't work. I thought it might work, but it's not very catchy. Okay, that is that. And thanks for checking out the What a Weird Week show. You can search for What a Weird Week wherever you get podcasts. If you want our show notes or a transcript of today's show, you can click shownotes.page. Shownotes.page. Also, thanks for tuning in on the live stream every weekend on Funhouse Radio. We are part of the programming. So shout out to the crew at Funhouse Radio. If you want to listen to Funhouse Radio, just ask your smart speaker to play Funhouse Radio. And now, in honor of Groundhog season, we're going to close out the show with the Groundhog Day Blues.
Somebody save me from Groundhog Jail. They're coming to grab me now, grab me by my tail. They think I know stuff about winter and spring, but I don't know jack squat about anything. All this predicting is very restricting. I ain't had a date in 5 years.
5 years.
And they think it's funny that if it is sunny, my shadow might drive me to tears. I'm a groundhog. Please don't put this pressure on me. I just want to go back to my hole. I don't like all these dignitaries. I'm a groundhog. Baby, it shouldn't be up to me to verify climate conditions. Is there still time to cross-country ski? I don't know. I'm just a large rat. I wanna go back to my hole.